In this video, I will go over reducing fractions. On the left-hand side, you see five different examples, varying from simpler ones to much difficult ones. Reducing fractions is based on the concept of understanding primes. If you have forgotten about primes or prime factorization, you can watch one of my videos on that exact topic. Now let us start with the first example, which is 14 over 36. And the way that I approach reduction of fractions is I basically will always take the smaller number, and it doesn't matter if it's the numerator or denominator, and I'll place it first. And then we have second, 36. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to draw myself this little table. Now, you don't have to do that at all. Just want to show it for purpose of illustration. And what I want to do is, because we are reducing fractions to its lowest terms, we want to see which prime will go into both numbers so that we can reduce it by that prime. Now, recall, so primes, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and it continues on. Now, those are the primes. These are the only ones you have to check. And again, if you want to know, you can watch the video on primes that I have recorded. Now, first off, I noticed that both numbers end in an even 4 and a 6, which means that both of them will be divisible by 2. Now, 2 goes into 14 7 times, and 2 goes into 36 18 times. Now, that has reduced this fraction to 7 over 18. And I will check if I can reduce it any further. So I always start with the smaller number. So in this case, it's 7. Now, 7 is actually a prime already, so I cannot reduce it, but I can check if 7 goes into 18 evenly. And unfortunately, it does not go evenly, which means that I will actually stop right here, because I cannot break this further into any other primes. So that is actually the answer. You might have seen this right away because it's a smaller fraction, and of course you can attempt it any way you like. Now, I will take the second example. So let me take the second example now. And in the second example, I have negative 30 over 147. So if you are running into fractions that are negative, just first check, is my answer going to be negative or positive? In this case, because we only have one negative, so the answer will stay negative. And now I can simply just worry about the numerator and denominator and see which prime will go into both. So it's much easier to always start with the lower number, as I mentioned in the first example. So I notice that 30, okay, is divisible by 2. However, I can't use 2 because 147 ends in a 7, which is odd. So 2 will not work for me. So if 2 doesn't work, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move over to the next prime and I'm going to check, well, will 3 work? Well, 3 goes into 30. Evenly, 10 times. Now let's check if 3 goes into 147. From the divisibility test, I know that 1 plus 4 plus 7. So in this case, that's 5 plus that is equal to 12. So the sum of digits is equal to 12, and I noticed, 3 goes into 147 as well. So I can use 3. So we said 3 goes into 30 10 times. And now, since I know that 3 goes into 147, I can do that division just to make sure to see what the number is. So 3 into 14, so 4 times 3. is 2, bring down the 7, and that goes in 9 times. So this becomes 49. So I have reduced my fraction to 10 over 49. Now I will continue to try to see. Well, 3 no longer fits into 10, so I will move over to 5. So 5 will work with 10, but remember it has to work for both. And 5 will not go into 49. So this now shows you, well, 5 is the last prime that actually goes into 10. That is the largest prime that will go in, because no bigger ones, like 7 or 11, will ever be able to reduce 10 for me. Once you notice that you have found the last prime, you stop. So in this case, my answer is negative 10 over 49, and I cannot reduce this any further. Because again, notice that 10, the only primes that go into this is 2 and 5. And both 2 or 5 do not go into 49, so I stop. That is my second example. So now let's take a look. Okay, and see my third example. So in my third example, I have 84 over 63. This is an improper fraction because the 84 is bigger. So let's write them down. So we have 84, 63. And as before, I will only check the smaller number first in terms of its primes. So that is 63. So now 2 will not go into 63. So then I will check 3. 3 does go into 63, and I see that because sum of digits, 6 plus 3, which is 9, and 9 is divisible by 3, so that works. And now I can check, well, will 3 work into 84? Well, 84, so sum of digits, 8 plus 4 is 12, and 3 is a prime that will work for 8 plus 4, which is 12, which means it also works for 84. So 3 works. So let's write 3 down, and let's now see how many times does 3 go into both of these numbers. So 3 into 8, so 2, that's 6 minus, bring down to 4, and that is 8. So this is 28. And now 3 into 63, you can check for yourself on the side, that will go in 21 times. So now I can check again. Will 3 work once more? And well, 3 works for 21, but it will no longer work for 28. So we are done with 3. So now, next, the prime is 5. 5 clearly doesn't go into 21. Next one is 7. 7 goes into 21, and it also goes into 28. So it goes in 4 times, and it goes in 3 times. And notice, that's as far as we can go, because now my 3 is already a prime. It does not go into 4. So I will stop. So this becomes 3, okay, and 4. So that is 4/3. And if you wanted, you can change this to a mixed number, and that will be 1 and 1/3. So that is example number 3. Example number 4. So let's check that one. Next. Now, I notice, so I have a negative on top, negative at the bottom. Well, negative and negative is equal to positive, so my answer will be positive. And now I have 91 and 260. And again, now to reduce it, I will go one by one by the primes. So 2. Well, 2 won't work with 91. So I have to move over to 3. 3 will not work with 91. And you can check that. So sum of digits, 9 plus 1 is 10. And 10 is not divisible by 3. So that doesn't work. What about 5? 5 clearly doesn't work because, again, divisibility test. So it ends in a 1. Therefore, I cannot divide by 5. Now, what about 7? So I can check now 7, which is my next one. So now 7, will it go into 91? So this one, unfortunately, because there is no direct divisibility, that's easy to remember. So I'm going to check it directly. So 7 into 9 goes once. And now that is 2 when I subtract. So it does work. So this will be, okay, so it goes in 7, 21. This would be 3. So 91 is 7 times 13. When the number gets a little bigger, I do like to keep this on the side for myself just to see so that I can reduce these, okay, and see that, okay, which ones will work. So now 7 worked for 91, but of course I have to check it for 260. And if I do that, so let's see, 7 into 260. So 7 into 26, 3 times, that's 21 minus, that's 5. And we have a problem because now I have 50. 7 does not go into 50. So 7 actually doesn't work. Now it worked for 91, but it doesn't work for 260. But I did come up with something useful because notice that the next prime, okay, and you see that 91 is 7 times 13. So now I can check, okay, well, 13 goes into 91 7 times. Does 13 go into 26? And you will see that indeed. So 13 goes into 91 7 times, and you can check for yourself that 13 goes into 260 20 times. So now I have reduced it by 13, so I have 7 over 20. 7 is a prime, so now can I reduce it any further? Only if it goes into 20, which it does not. And that is the sign that I must stop. So in recapping this, you have basically you take your fraction and all you do is you check the primes that go into both numerator and denominator until you cannot find any further primes. And this last example, which is a great one to test yourself and see, let us try that. So we have now the last one, 275 over 2310. It's highly unlikely that you're going to be asked something like this at some point, but at least it provides you with some guidance to see how well you know this process. So the process is, number one, we pick the smaller number, and now we check which prime will go into that smaller number. Now, I actually right away see that I have a 5 here and a 0 here. So 5 will definitely work for both of these. So how many times does 5 go into 275? So let me do that. 5 into 27, 5 times. When I subtract, I'll get 2. 5 drops down, so that's another 5. And now, so this will be 55. And now let's check How many times does 5 go into the bigger number? So 5 into 23 goes 4 times. 4 times 5 is 20. Subtract, we get 3, bring down the 1. 5 into 31 goes 6 times. That gives me 30. Subtract, I'll get 1. Bring down the 0. 5 into 10, 2 times. So now I have reduced this to 55 and 462. Okay, so going to the primes. So we used 5. Now, 2 does not work because 55 is odd. 3, notice, will not work because 5 plus 5 is 10. So that's not divisible by 3. We just checked 5. Now, will 5 work again? It does work for 55, but it will not work for 462. So I have to check the next one, which is 7. 7 does not go into 55. Next one, next prime is 11. 11 will go into 55. Now let's check if 11 goes into 462. So 11 into 46, 4 times, that will be 44. Subtract, bring down the 2. Great. 11 into 22 goes 2 times. So 11 works for both. So this is 42, and 11 into 55 goes 5 times. Now, 5 is prime. Notice that 5 does not go into 42, so I stop. So my answer here becomes 5 over 42, where the two primes that worked were 5 and 11. Okay, you can test yourself on these in reducing fractions. Remember, it's all about primes. Thank you for watching.